undeniable.
We catch touchdown Spartans. It's Lucas. The end zone caught by Snyder. Touchdown Spartans.
We undeniable.
Spartans. Dylan has.
We undeniable. We undeniable.
For grabs, a jumping catch is made. Kill Fugan.
We undeniable.
Jersey Rob. 15, 10, 5. Dives for the end zone. He's pushed in. Touchdown Spartans.
We undeniable.
Welcome into the Bixby Spartan Football Coaches Show, which is brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Eat more chicken. Let's talk about Broken Arrow and Lauren Montgomery. This is a team you hadn't seen in a while, except in some preseason type stuff. And in this move to 6A1, this was an inevitable big matchup because of the proximity and, man, great crowd.
Great crowd, without a doubt. We hadn't seen Broken Arrow since 2013 in the season, so it was exciting to have a great home environment, and I think we sold out of tickets. Both sides were jam-packed. The place was loud. And, you know, I always mention it, but playing a home game Friday night at Lee Snyder Field is just awesome.
Yeah, outstanding environment all the way around. We're going to get some highlights here in just a bit. But with a big week like this, obviously the practices have to be on point. That gets us to our practice players of the week.
Yeah, our practice player captain this week is actually our starting running back, Jersey Robb. But Jersey, when you watch a videotape of practice, is always 100% flying around. Does an excellent job setting an example for everyone out there. And then our next guy, a unique thing years ago, was actually a kickoff kid and got to be with us on the sidelines, be with us in the locker room for pregame, everything like that. Jackson Summer was our practice player of the week. And so Jackson just always does a phenomenal job. He's a Bixby Spartan through and through, and this just means so much to him. So it's exciting to see him be rewarded for that.
Practice Players of the Week, sponsored by BTC Broadband. First half highlights with the Broken Arrow Tigers when we come back.
Off Havens gives it up, running right, off the defender at the 5. Jet Turner veers into the end zone. Touchdown, Spartan.
The Bixby Football Coaches Show is brought to you by Chick-fil-A, Eat More Chicken, Baker Pools. All your pool needs are at BakerPoolsOK.com. BTC Broadband, stay connected with us. American Waste, big enough to serve you and small enough to know you. Nallen Orthodontics, powered by Smile Doctors. Matthews Ford, come get your Ford certified vehicle today. Dotson Snyder Financial, call Jason for all your financial needs. Roush Coleman Homes, improving quality of life, one home at a time. Oklahoma Promo, products that inspire. And by Castle Rock Homes.
Hey, I'm Jackie, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is the chicken. It is golden brown, so juicy, so delicious. To all my fellow non-breakfast people, this chicken biscuit is something different. It's the perfect savory start to my day.
Hi, I'm Gary, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A chicken biscuit is that it's unexpected. I'm a big biscuit guy, but chicken for breakfast is delicious. You can taste all of the flavors just all at once. Once you try it, there's no turning back.
My name is Heather Simon. I'm a mortgage lender in Tulsa, Oklahoma. For the mortgage lending business, it's about speed and getting things done. I have not had any problems whatsoever. The service is just amazing.
With affordable business solutions like Tech Protect, Cloud Communications, Automated Texting, and SD-WAN, it's clear why customers are making the switch to BTC Broadband.
I'm a huge BTC fan.
So the Bixby Spartans at home, Lee Snyder Field, to take on the Broken Arrow Tigers. Haven't seen them in season, this coach said, since 2013. First half highlights, let's take a look at those. These are brought to you by Matthews Ford.
Let's go ahead and take a look here. Coming out, Connor Kirby at quarterback right here, and we've got a little speed option look right here going with Connor toting the rock, and Cordell is pitch man right here. Excellent, excellent blocking right there. We have Carter Brenneman. Lucas out leading the way right there, Jersey Robb. And then we spit the wide receiver screen out here to Jersey Robb, and he's just short of the end zone right there. And then we come back and quick snap it right there, and Connor gets into the end zone. So missed a little bit of that first score, but we're still in pretty good shape. And then you'll notice Hank Puckett right there showing off his speed to chase down Broken Arrow's quarterback. And then they hit a big tunnel screen to tie the game up. So super proud of the way we responded right here. Like we've been doing the last couple weeks, the kickoff return team has been extremely effective. And Cordell right here takes it back, puts us in great field position to respond. And then we come back. Austin Havens at quarterback throws the corner out right here to Christian Kaiser. Christian goes up, high points the ball, comes down in the end zone right there. Excellent play to go ahead and regain that lead right there. And quarterback run game here out of number 7 for Broken Arrow. Jacob Snyder from his corner position coming up tackling. Those corners, you know, they have to tackle, and our guys have been doing a good job right there. Tyson Williams doing a good job playing the contested ball from the back end. And then Connor Kirby right here on the quarterback counter. Excellent play right there by Broken Arrow, number 3. Making the shoestring tackle, getting out of the pocket, hitting the comeback on third down right here. Kel Fugate comes back, catches it, and then shows you what he can do with his feet, outrunning a bunch of guys in man coverage there. So coming back here, Broken Arrow tries to go back to the tunnel screen. This time we're all over it. Connor Kirby, Jake Snyder in on that. Connor Kirby from his outside linebacker position setting a hard edge there. Running the speed sweep action and throw the ball off of it on the backside bender right there to Kel Fugate. Hard play action coming back. Cordell Goldsby gets it on the out route. Does a good job picking up some positive yardage. And then Jet Turner right here in at the tailback position. Jet had an excellent night. Jumped in. Due to injury right there. And then hard play action, Connor Kirby with a little jump pass right there to Lucas. Luke just showing off his talent at the tight end / wide receiver position. Jacob Snyder, excellent shoestring tackle. You can tell he's an excellent wrestler in our wrestling program. Broken Arrow coming back here with a little trickeration. Excellent coverage. Jacob Snyder is all over it. We'd seen that play in practice all week. Jacob does a good job intercepting that. Proud of our guys right here, not getting any blocks in the back or anything like that. And then Jacob gets his helmet ripped off and tackled right there. And then they had a personal foul, had a guy ejected. And then we come back with excellent field position. Connor Kirby in behind Evan McClure, blocking right here. Austin Havens from his quarterback position. He finds Lucas in the corner of the end zone for the sliding catch and another great score. Taking a look at the excellent crowd back there in the background, tons of fans come back here on the quarterback counter. Excellent block by Lucas. Connor Kirby showing off his speed in the open field. Excellent runner with the football in his hands. Throw the wide receiver screen right here. Good job by Cordell making a guy miss. Sam McCormick doing a good job not holding right there. That's tough when you're out on the perimeter a lot. Sam really coming on doing some good stuff. Broken Arrow coming back here with a counter. Brandon Hobbs on the tackle right there. Cooper Parker, sophomore, stepping in from linebacker position. Defensive player of the week doing good stuff. And there was the sauce right there. Kaysen Hatley making another big play, getting good pressure right here. Mike Incremono on the sack, lone sack of the evening. And then we come back here, Dez Traylor, those guys running counter, and we spit the bubble screen out here to Jacob Snyder, miss a block out on the edge, and so Broken Arrow, give them credit, they did some good stuff. Jet Turner getting in the end zone right here, doing a good job making a guy miss, getting vertical, getting behind his shoulder pads, getting that ball into the end zone. Mike Incremona right here, I think Hank Puckett in on that tackle as well, got everything bottled up, and then Kel Fugate ends up being there on the backside, fitting his gap, and so defense really doing some good stuff. Cordell Goldsby right here getting an excellent block by Lucas, just out there absolutely driving his feet, battling, trying to get those extra yards for a ball carrier. Austin Havens stepping back right here, misses the middle route from the tight end, keeps the play alive right here, finds Jet Turner down the sidelines. And then right here, we hit the counter play. Jet Turner doing another good job, making some guys miss, getting vertical. And then we hit the quarterback counter follow here. Austin Havens getting into the end zone behind some excellent blocking right there. Brody Duffel and the guys. That takes us to a score of 56-7 at halftime.
All right, the Spartans winning big at home. We'll have your second half highlights when we come back.
Come by Matthews Ford today and experience the Matthews Ford difference with our quick lane service. Tires, brakes, batteries, oil changes, you name it, and the factory-trained experts at Quick Lane can handle it on your schedule. Come see your friends at the Quick Lane.
Our experience with Now and Orthodontics has been excellent. We enjoy coming here as a family. All of my kids have a great experience through their orthodontia treatment, from the front office staff to the back office staff. They have been extremely professional and courteous. We just love our overall experience here at Nalan Orthodontics.
Nalan Orthodontics, transforming smiles, free consultations, and 0% financing.
My name is Jasmine, and a little thing I love about the Chick-fil-A Grilled Chicken Club is the wonderfully marinated and juicy chicken breast. The marinade actually reminds me of my mother's cooking. You know, marinades, usually they take time, and you can tell that it was put together with love.
My name is Meredith, and a little thing I love about Chick-fil-A's mac and cheese is the oven-toasted, cheesy top layer. If home had a flavor, it would be Chick-fil-A's mac and cheese. I'm passionate about it.
The Spartans are cruising at half over the Broken Arrow Tigers, 56-7, huge crowd. And Lauren, you know, you knew with Broken Arrow, a lot of talent. How are you feeling about your team right now with this commanding a lead at halftime?
Well, obviously, we felt good. We weren't expecting to go in at halftime with a 56-7 lead, but we knew that they had hit the big play. But other than that, our defense was pretty buckled down. Offense was moving the ball. We wanted to go ahead and look at maybe pulling one or two of our key guys at halftime, but knew that we couldn't just completely take guys out because Broken Arrow is extremely talented and they have the ability to score fast. And so we didn't want them to creep back into the game, want it to become a dogfight. And so slowly we started to put other guys in and wanted to work really hard to keep our guys healthy.
All right, the Spartans with a big lead. Second half, highlights brought to you by Dotson Snyder Financial. Let's take a look.
Coming out here, second half, Connor Kirby right here. Really just coming back. He got his hand cut in the first half and had to go in the locker room and get it stitched up. And so we didn't get him back until the second half there and got a couple snaps out of him. And you see Cody Kruhl right there doing a good job carrying the football. Cody did a really nice job. And then we come back and we hit Cord Nolan, just a freshman, but making big time plays at the tight end position. We hit the hitch pass wide receiver screen out there to Cody Kruhl and continue to move the football. And Cody does a good job right there showing his strength, making a guy miss. Cody's playing a ton of outside linebacker for us and then also has shown to be an excellent tailback. We kind of found that out last year in some of our JV games when he came in there and was quite the playmaker. And so good to see him out on the offensive side of the ball, making some stuff happen. Young sophomore Cooper Parker right there ended up playing the whole game at linebacker. Then we run the counter play in behind in with Cody, and Cody doing a good job showing off his wheels right here. Clay Peters, quarterback, junior, Clay doing great things on both sides of the ball, was probably one of our most effective players. Friday night, hands off the ball right here to sophomore Bodie Carroll. Bodie doing a good job with his legs. And then we come back and we run the quarterback sweep to Clay once again, and Clay's just so fast. Excellent ball carrier, does a good job throwing the ball down the field as well. Then we run the stretch right here. Got Clay right here. We just ended up slightly short on fourth down. And then we spit the wide receiver screen out. And then Blake Hogshooter, sophomore, doing good things. Excellent wide receiver, big tall target. And then right there, Bodie Carroll gets into the end zone for the touchdown. And then defense is out here. We got a lot of guys on defense flying around doing good stuff. Got some of our reserve guys in, but really getting after it, taking advantage of their opportunity. Got Brayson Trusty, senior right here, number 18, getting out on the edge on the speed sweep. Brayson's been out the last couple weeks, had a little broken hand, but did a good job carrying the football right there with the cast. And then that takes us to a final score of 77-17, Mark.
All right, time for our final stats, which are brought to you by American Waste Control.
Extremely effective night offensively with 35 first downs and 637 yards of total offense. Broken Arrow had 233 yards of total offense. We had 346 through the air, 291 on the ground. We talked about penalties. Unfortunately, we had 10 penalties for 100 yards. Still trying to get that fixed. Four personal fouls, just completely unacceptable. And then turnovers, turned the ball over three times, one fumble, two interceptions. So we've got to work really hard to get that fixed as we progress towards the end of the season. Austin Havens was 12 of 21 for 203 yards and three touchdowns. Clay Peters was 6 of 10 for 79 yards. Rushing, Connor Kirby, our leading rusher, had 12 carries for 105 yards. Clay Peters, 8 carries for 60 yards. Cody Krull, 6 carries for 49. Receiving, Kel Fugate with a big night, 4 receptions for 89 yards, and we saw his touchdown there earlier. Cordell Goldsby, 4 receptions for 52 yards. Jacob Snyder, 2 receptions for 50, and then Jet Turner had 3 for 29 yards. Defensively, Jacob Snyder, Hank Puckett, Cooper Parker all tied with 8 tackles as their leading tacklers. And Dylan Haz, as we mentioned, really starting to get healthy, doing good stuff from his safety position with 6 tackles. And then finally, Big Mike Incremona, we saw his sack on the evening. Mike's continuing to grow, get better in our program, doing good things on that defensive line.
All right, so huge victory over Broken Arrow at home. Now you're going to take on a team from the West, Westmore. What do we know about the Jaguars?
We haven't played them since 2017, and Coach Lorenzo Williams doing really good stuff with that program. They've got really good athletes all over the field. They run the stretch play really well, got a mobile quarterback. Defensively, they play a little bit more of a unique scheme than we're used to, kind of run a 3-4 defense, but stack up some guys in the middle. So on a short week, we got a lot to prepare for.
All right, Spartans and Westmore, fall break, so it's a Thursday night game at Lee Snyder. We're going to come back and we'll have our Now in Orthodontics Player of the Week.
Come by Matthews Ford today and experience the Matthews Ford difference with our quick lane service. Tires, brakes, batteries, oil changes, you name it, and the factory-trained experts at Quick Lane can handle it on your schedule. Come see your friends at the Quick Lane.
What comes to mind when you think of trash? Probably just glad somebody else handles it, right? Well, American Waste Control founder Kenny Burkett started hauling waste and recyclables in Tulsa over 50 years ago, and he is still taking the trash out today. That's not all. Kenny's company is the presenting sponsor of the annual Tulsa Christmas Parade, and he's proud to sponsor Bixby Spartan football. Come out and cheer for our Bixby Spartans with your local waste company and recycling hauler each home game.
My name is Heather Simon. I'm a mortgage lender in Tulsa, Oklahoma. For the mortgage lending business, it's about speed and getting things done. I have not had any problems whatsoever. The service is just amazing.
With affordable business solutions like Tech Protect, cloud communications, automated texting, and SD-WAN, it's clear why customers are making the switch to BTC broadband.
I'm a huge BTC fan.
Our experience with Now in Orthodontics has been excellent. We enjoy coming here as a family. All of my kids have a great experience through their orthodontia treatment, from the front office staff to the back office staff. They have been extremely professional and courteous. We just love our overall experience here at Now in Orthodontics.
Now in Orthodontics, transforming smiles, free consultations, and 0% financing.
Now in Orthodontics presents our Player of the Week, and it's senior Jacob Lael who joins us, offensive lineman. We'll talk about you playing tackle and guard. Jacob, welcome to the show.
Thanks for having me.
All right, well, let's talk about your first-year starter, and you've moved a couple times now. You played tackle, now you're playing guard. Just talk about the mindset, offensive line in general, and what it takes to be consistent there?
Well, I don't know. Consistency is just something that's always been easy to me because it's just doing the same thing every day. I'm a creature of habit. It makes it easier, knowing my schedule day to day and doing it, following through with it. And I just never really had the thought about not going in and doing working out and training at right tackle and left guard and all this and just doing whatever needs to be done for me to be useful to the team. So that's always been easy for me.
Well, Jacob, what are the differences between tackle and guard?
Well, tackle, I don't know, it's all pretty much the same offensive line, but guard, you're going to have to, you know, learn to be a little bit more athletic because you got to get up and run sometimes, which has been a little bit difficult for me, but working on it. And then right tackle, it's a different ball game, but it's still offensive line, so it's got some similarities in there.
Well, as a senior now, you get to be, you know, see the younger guys coming through, and you've been a younger guy and come on through the program. Overall, how would you judge the way you guys are playing? I mean, you're obviously undefeated, but all the way through, how do you feel about this team?
I feel like we have some sophomores and definitely juniors. Like I'm looking at Duffel, Kaysen Hatley, Justin Kirk, guys like that on the junior squad. And then we've got people like Landon Durfee on the sophomores that are doing everything they can and learning the plays to be better for the whole team, make us all better.
What's your experience been like? Now, you moved here, as you mentioned, fourth grade from Antlers there in southeast Oklahoma. So just tell us what it was like to move here and get ingrained in the Bixby culture.
Well, it was definitely different from a tiny little school like Antlers moving here. It was hard to get used to for a little while, but after a few years, you know, working in, especially after I started playing football here, it all started becoming a whole lot easier and making more sense.
What would you say is your favorite part of playing football overall?
I enjoyed Friday Night Lights. You know, practicing, you got to do it and all this, which you do. And then the reward is getting to play on Friday.
What do you like to do, just say, when you are not playing football, what do you enjoy?
Well, one of my favorite parts of the whole program is lifting, and I enjoy doing that even outside of football. And then other things, you know, like just having a good time, you know.
Probably the lifting thing doesn't hurt at all.
That adds to it.
Yeah, fully embracing that. Congratulations, Jacob, on a great season so far. You've got a lot of football ahead of you and some more Friday Night Lights and some more great games. So congratulations.
Thank you.
Thanks for joining us, Jacob Lale, senior offensive lineman, tackle, now guard. We're going to talk about the young guys. We'll have our youth team of the week when we come back.
Come by Matthews Ford today and experience the Matthews Ford difference with our quick lane service. Tires, brakes, batteries, oil changes, you name it, and the factory trained experts at Quick Lane can handle it on your schedule. Come see your friends at the Quick Lane.
My name is Heather Simon. I'm a mortgage lender in Tulsa, Oklahoma. For the mortgage lending business, it's about speed and getting things done. I have not had any problems whatsoever. The service is just amazing.
With affordable business solutions like Tech Protect, cloud communications, automated texting, and SD-WAN, it's clear why customers are making the switch to BTC broadband.
I'm a huge BTC fan.
What comes to mind when you think of trash? Probably just glad somebody else handles it, right? Well, American Waste Control founder Kenny Burkett started hauling waste and recyclables in Tulsa over 50 years ago, and he is still taking the trash out today. That's not all. Kenny's company is the presenting sponsor of the annual Tulsa Christmas Parade, and he's proud to sponsor Bixby Spartan Football. Come out and cheer for our Bixby Spartans with your local waste company and recycling hauler each home game.
Go down.
Welcome back, and it's time for our Baker Pools Youth Team of the Week. We head all the way back to second grade blue here in Bixby. And Nick Crosby, the head coach, joins us. Nick, good to have you.
Thanks for having me.
All right, let's talk just in general about how your season's gone so far.
So we got a special group of guys this year. We're off to a 7-0 start. Got a couple games left to go, and really just getting going at the right time here.
All right, dropping the hammer on some people. Take a look. We've got some highlights here. Offense, defense. We're going to start with the offense. Just tell us a little bit about what you guys are able to do there.
Sure. So second grade is still Mighty Might football, so we play 8-man. We typically have gone in shotgun split back formation this year. Do primarily run plays, probably 80-20, but we have thrown the ball quite a bit this year. So we've got several passing plays, a couple hundred yards of passing offense, and put together, you know, quite a good stat sheet between our multiple ball carriers and our pass catchers. So,
all right, let's flip the field here and take a look now at some of the things on your defense.
So yeah, again, we're pretty pre-prescribed here on Mighty Might. So we run a 4-1 offense. We have some big guys up front that can get after the ball. You know, we've even our defensive end had an interception in the first game against Jinx Silver, which was real exciting for him, for our team, everybody. But yeah, we got some big guys up front that love to get off the ball. We've got, you know, great skilled players behind them that can run to the ball and hit pretty hard and wrap up well and tackle. So,
well, Nate, let's talk about just in general what your experience has been like coaching so far. Is this your first, second year to coach?
So this is my second year. I was with Bixby Blue last year for first grade, and we had five returning players, but got seven new players this year, and they've been great. The new kids have picked stuff up really well. You know, the kids are really hungry to learn and really into, you know, making tackles, scoring points, and getting better every week. So it's been a real pleasure to coach these kids.
Well, I know you guys also kind of moved around some practice field areas with all the construction, kind of some new faces. You're driving down the street and you look over, hey, there's a practice.
Yes, and that's been something that we've gotten through, and our kids have been troopers. So, you know, we pull some stickers out of the kids every now and then, but it toughens them up, and we get through it, and they're making the best of it. So
there you go. You just push through it, and I imagine you have a great year. Obviously, to this point, you should do extremely well the rest of the way. Congratulations on a great season.
Thank you very much. I appreciate it.
All right, Nate Crosby, head coach, second grade blue, and that's our Baker Pools Youth Team of the Week. This week, Spartans taking on Westmore at home Thursday night. We'll see you next week.
The Bixby Football Coaches Show was brought to you by Chick-fil-A. Eat more chicken. Baker Pools. All your pool needs are at BakerPoolsOK.com. BTC Broadband, stay connected with us. American Waste, big enough to serve you and small enough to know you. Nallen Orthodontics, powered by Smile Doctors. Matthews Ford, come get your Ford-certified vehicle today. Dotson Snyder Financial, call Jason for all your financial needs. Roush Coleman Homes, improving quality of life, one home at a time. Oklahoma Promo, products that inspire. And by Castle Rock Homes.